Hey guys, and welcome back to Day Film Photography. So today I'm going to show you how to make this simple composite image using just three layers in Photoshop. So all we're going to do is bring in our background layer, and then what you want to do is make a copy. So there's two ways of doing that. You can click on your background and then press Ctrl and J on your keyboard, or drag this background layer down to the layer palette thing down at the end here and let go, and it will give you a background copy. Now my background has been pre-edited already because I've dragged it in and I've made the final adjustments that I want for my image. So you go ahead and just do the same with yours. You can do that by tweaking it as you want in Photoshop. And then we're going to add in the model which we have here. And there's a numerous ways of doing this, but the best way I find is to use the quick selection tool here, which is this little tool up here. And you can either click it or press W on your keyboard. So click on the model that you want to cut out and hold your mouse button down, or use your pen and tablet if that's your preference, and just drag around the whole model, just ensuring that you have every part of her in the little marching ants there that you can see going around her. Now don't worry if you make any mistakes, because this can all be fixed later. I'm just going to show you briefly and roughly how to cut the models off your background. So make sure you go around, select her hair. Take your time doing this, there's no rush. It's just you and yourself. Okay, and once you're happy with your selection, what you'll need to do next is just up here on the top of your Photoshop palette is click Refine Edge. And you'll see what that has removed the model from the background now, but there are a few errors in and around the place that we can fix. Okay, initially in here, don't touch anything in this palette over here. You just want to leave that as it is. And make sure that you've clicked on the brush icon here, which is this one. And then just carefully around the edge of the image, just paint out those little pieces that you don't want in. And you might see some little errors here as well that we can fine tune in a little while, once we get it into Photoshop. So paint around the whole edge of the image and just try and tidy up the edge, including her hair as well. And just give it a tidy up. And once you're happy with that, you can just come out and on the output selection in this little dialog box, you want to click on layer mask and then click OK. What that will do now is remove the lady from the background in her own layer mask, and then make sure that you click on the mask itself, which is the black and white one over here, and then drag your image off. Click on your move tool at the top and then drag your image onto your background. Okay, and like you can see now, there's a few mistakes. If you zoom in, there's some errors on the model itself. So what you want need to do is click on the layer mask as well here and select the paintbrush tool, which is this one, and make sure your foreground color is set to black, and then you can go ahead. Actually, make sure that up here in the brush palette selection tool that your opacity is at 100% and your flow is at 100%, and make sure that your hard brush selected, which is either this one or this one, and then just paint around the edge of the image, and you can see that it's removing the pieces that we don't want. If you make any mistakes in here, like drag your mouse across accidentally, then it's easy to fix. You just switch your foreground color back to white, and then you can paint those bits back in. Very simple. And then if you just, so white is reveal and black is delete, is remove. So again, carefully go around the very edge of the image, take your time with it, and just to fine tune all the bits that you might have missed out the first time. And again, with just the places under the arm, just to match it to the background. Take your time going around inside those areas and just paint them all out. And around the whole model herself, so around the whole edge and even with the hair. So around the hair, what I suggest doing is reduce the opacity and the flow down a little bit on the brush. Increase the brush size and just kind of brush in around those areas. And just fine tune it how you want yourself. And keep going until you're happy with the results that you want. Now, because I've done this already, I'm just going to remove this layer and reveal the one that I've done already. And there you go, you can see the model is now placed in her position on the background. And again, you can move the model anywhere you want. So you can even have her over this side, but then you're going to have a lot of negative space on this side. So you want her, say, around here. And obviously the light is coming in behind her, so it suits this image perfectly. And now you just want to add a bit of shadow to the background, because there would be shadow with the light hitting her from the direction it is, and it's really lighting up her hair. So to add shadow, just create a layer underneath the model, which I've done here. Just going to turn it on. And you can see the shadow just appeared there. And I'm just going to do it again, just so I can show you guys how to paint in your shadow. So again, this time make sure you've got a soft brush. Reduce your opacity on the brush down to about 14 or 15%. And again, with the flow, about 14 or 15% as well. Increase your brush size a little bit. And then just start painting in the shadow on that layer that we just created. Apologies if you hear a lot of mouse clicks. I'm just not using my pen tablet at the moment. Just to show you guys how I'm doing this. So fine tune it yourself. So the shadow should be where it should be, underneath the feet. And then across, coming from the direction that the light is shining. And once you're happy, keep going and fine tune it to your own liking. And then what you want to do is change that layer. Move it, my one, because one was on earlier. To multiply, so you do that by clicking on these little arrows here. Normally it will be on normal, but you want to click on multiply or overlay. The multiplier just reveals the sand underneath, and overlay will do the same thing. And if you increase it too much, that's the kind of shadow you're going to have. So what you want to do is bring your opacity right down until you just got a soft shadow cast across the ground. Okay, so once you're happy and you've got your model and your shadow completed the way you like it, now it's time to finalize and merge all those layers together. So you do that by clicking on the final layer, the top layer here. Press Control, Alt, Shift, and E on your keyboard. Oops. And that would create a flattened version of the image, but still maintaining the layers underneath. So you can see that if you turn those on or off, it has no effect, because now the only layer that matters is the final one. So make sure that you don't do the Control, Alt, Shift, E thing until you're very happy with how you want the final image to look, before doing your final tweaking with the editing. So I've done mine already. Again, I should remove that one. So there's my final image, and then I've done a final edit like this, so you can just see the slight light change there, just to balance the whole image together. Right, what I've done then is, once you've flattened your image or merged it, keep that layer open and then go to Filter, Nik Collection. Now the Nik Collection is free from Google. If you want to go to Google and type in Nik Collection for Photoshop, you can go ahead and download it yourself, and you get a whole load of filter effects and preloads and presets made for Photoshop and Lightroom. And they include HDR effects, Color Effects Pro 4, and Analog Effects Pro 2, which is the one I'm going to use. So click on Analog Effects Pro 2 and just allow that to put the image together and import it into its own piece of software, and then we can have a little mess around in there and choose some presets and tweak them to our liking as well. So you can see now the image is loading up. Just take a little bit of time, but it's worth it because you can finalize the image just to your liking and keep it the image looking nice and finalized for your particular style. Okay, it's just processing it now. Here we go. Like I say, there's loads of presets with the Color FX Pro and this Analog X Pro. And you can see now already that it's decided to give me some presets loaded. So you can scroll down through the files that you want and choose the one that best suits your mood or the mood that you want for the picture. This one, Classic Camera 7, looked quite nice. And again, these can be tweaked as well, so you don't have to go with the final preset that they have over here. You can actually tweak them a bit as well, so you can bring it to mess around with these sliders, have it as strong as you want, as weak as you want, change the color just by clicking around it. So go ahead and just choose the one that you want before deciding on how you want the final image to look. So I've done one already, and I'm just going to turn that on, and that's how I want my final image to look. So there we go, that's the final image in Photoshop, and that's a quick and simple, easy way to make your composites. If you have any questions, please feel free to stick it in the comments box down there. Otherwise, I would love if you hit the subscribe button or smash it even. It's down there somewhere on the left hand side. If you like my videos, please give me a thumbs up at least. Thanks very much, and I will see you next time. Take it easy. Bye-bye.